Welcome everyone. Today we'll be talking about the poem Voice of the Rain written by Walt Whitman, which is from your book Hornbill. First of all, we'll go through the introduction of this poem. As I already said, it is written by Walt Whitman and basically it is a conversation between the poet and the rain. The poet asks a question to the rain and to which the rain is answering, and the poet has translated the answer in his own words. Now we have the line-wise explanation here. The poet is asking the rain, "Who art thou? Who are you?" Said I to the soft falling shower. Soft falling shower here is the rain. Then the poet says that, which, strange to tell, gave me an answer. Though the poet got the answer, then also he says, it is very strange to say that I got an answer from the rain, and as here translated, the answer is translated here. The rain answered, "I am the poem of earth," said the voice of rain. The voice of rain answered me that I am poem of earth. "Eternal I rise, impalpable out of the land and the bottomless sea." The rain says, "I am of eternal nature. I am impalpable." Eternal means everlasting. Impalpable means something that cannot be touched. "Out of the land and bottomless sea." And I rise from the land and bottomless sea. Here we have figures of speech in this stanza. That is, when the poem, when the rain says that, "I am the poem of earth." Here, the rain has been personified as if it is a human being. So here, figure of speech here in this line is personification. Now here, if we see here that bottomless sea, the sea is supposed to be bottomless here. That also is a kind of exaggeration. Okay, so the figure of speech here is hyperbole. That is hyperbole. Where if the things are exaggerated, then this figure of speech is formed there. Now, one more figure of speech here is that I am the poem of earth. Rain is comparing itself to the song of earth, to the poem of earth. So here again in the same line, we have the figure of speech that is metaphor. In metaphor, the comparison is made between two unlike things. So what are the two unlike things? First one is rain and second one is poem. Both are not related to each other at all. Now, next slide. Rain continues, "Upward to heaven whence vaguely formed, altogether changed and yet the same." The rain says that when I reach upward to heaven here is sky, whence means where. When I reach to sky, there vaguely means unclear, something that is not clear, formed, altogether changed and yet the same. The rain says that when I reach to sky, there I take the form of clouds, there my form changes, but originally I am same. In the next line, the rain continues, "I descend" means I come down, "to lave the draught." Lave means bathe or wash. "I come down to wash the draught" means here finish the draught. Atomies means tiny particles found in atmosphere, dust layers of globe. When I descend, what I do? I provide water to waterless places and I clean the surrounding also, earth surrounding also, that is full of atomies and dust layers. And I clean that as well. Globe here means earth. "And all that in them without me were seeds only latent unborn." The rain also here claims that if suppose I would not have fallen, then all the seeds which were hidden under the soil would have never been born. They would have been unborn because I am the one which gives life to seeds. The last stanza, "And forever by day and night I give back life to my own origin." Rain says, Forever and ever I keep on giving life to my own origin and make pure and beautify it. I make earth pure means clean, beautify it means by giving water. If everything becomes green and full of life, then obviously things look beautiful. The last two lines are not the part of the rain's answer. This poet is suggesting from his side. The poet says, for song issuing from its birthplace, after fulfillment, wandering, reckoned or unreckoned, duly with love returns. Here the poet says that the rain is like a song that originates from its birthplace, just like the heart of the singer. As a song originates from the heart of a singer, similarly the rain originates from the earth, and it travels far and wide places, travels to far and wide places, but comes back and fulfills the needs of its origin, needs of earth. It finally comes back to the place from where it originated, and whether it is called or not, whether the deeds of rain are welcomed or not, whether what rain does, it is welcomed, it is praised or not, rain duly returns its love to its origin, that is earth. That was all from the poem's explanation part. Now we'll quickly recapitulate the whole poem with the help of this summary. In the poem, the poet asks the soft falling shower, who are you? To which the rain replies that she is the poem of earth. It is a strange thing from the rain to reply, a strange thing for the rain to reply to the poet. The rain told the poet that she cannot be touched as she rises in the form of water vapor. Why it is impalpable? Because it rises in the form of water vapor, and it reaches to the sky from the land and the bottomless sea. It changes its shape, yet it remains same. Means it takes the form of clouds. Then also originally it is same because it is made of water. The vapor changes into clouds due to condensation, but originally the vapors are also water droplets. It falls back on the surface of earth to provide water to the drought prone areas and to beautify and purify the earth, that is its birthplace. It provides life to the seeds inside the earth and helps them grow. The rain doesn't care if anyone bothers about her deeds or not. What work rain does, if it is praised or not, rain doesn't care at all. She completes her work, she completes her cycle, her water cycle, and comes back home. In the end, the poet compares the rain like a song, as they both share a common journey. The song originates from the heart of the singer, travels across to fulfill the aim, and comes back with due love for the singer. Means when the singer sings a song, what is his aim? That he wants to convey his heart's desire, he wants to convey his feeling to other people, and his song travels and does that work. Similarly, the rain also originates, travels far and wide, does its work, and comes back to its origin, that is earth. That was all from the summary part. Now, if we discuss the theme of the poem, there are two prominent themes in it. First one is importance of rain, what rain does, and second one is water cycle, how rain originates from land and bottomless sea, how it goes, takes the form of the clouds and descends and comes back and beautifies earth and gives life to earth. That was all for this poem. Thank you, everybody.